good evening and a warm welcome, viewers who have switched to watch Youthfolio today. In our series, we show you happenings from around the Northeast, information on the Northeast and its people, sports, enterprise, opportunities, culture, lifestyles of the tribes, festivals, health and lots more. We have many interesting and informative stories on the queue. Watch on. First comes our current issues segment.
Northeast bids tearful farewell to its martyrs. Border Security Force and Border Guards Bangladesh exchange Diwali sweets across the international border. Wanted Alpha I Deputy Commander-in-Chief Drishti Rajkhoa surrenders in Assam. Garo tribe celebrates 100 drum Wangala festival. Assam Rifles organizes massive COVID awareness and plantation drives in the Northeast. Tripura celebrates Annakut festival with great gaiety. Indian Army Jawan from Assam, Haradhan Chandra Roy, who recently embraced martyrdom in the Uri sector of Jammu and Kashmir due to heavy shelling by Pakistani Army across the LOC, was bid a solemn farewell in Guwahati, led by Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal, who laid wreath on his mortal remains and announced an ex gratia of rupees 20 lakh while grieving that no loss of lives can be compensated with money.
ভারতবর্ষৰ নিৰাপত্তাৰ স্বাৰ্থত বীৰ শ্বহীদ হৰধন চন্দ্ৰ ৰয় আত্মবলিদান দিলে। তেখেতৰ আজি যিখিনি কষ্ট আৰু ত্যাগ দেশবাসীয়ে শ্ৰদ্ধাৰে স্মৰণ কৰিছে আৰু তেখেত সদায় আমাৰ মাজত অমৰ হৈ ৰ'ব। দেশৰ একতা, অখণ্ডতা আৰু সাৰ্বভৌমত্বৰ বাবে তেখেতে সর্বস্ব ত্যাগ করলে। গতি সেইগৰাকী মহান বীরক মই হৃদয়ের গভীর শ্রদ্ধাঞ্জলি জ্ঞাপন করছো। আর তেখেতৰ আদর্শে প্রতিজন ভারতীয় নাগরিকে যাতে দেশের স্বার্থত সর্বস্ব ত্যাগ করবলে প্রস্তুত থাকে, তারবাবে আমি সকলে প্রতিটি মুহূর্ততে নিজকে প্রস্তুত করে রাখব লাগবে। মই বীর শহীদ হরধন চন্দ্র রয় দেবর পরিয়ালবর্গলৈ গভীর সমবেদনা জ্ঞাপন করছো। আর অসম সরকার তরফের পৰা তেখেতসকলৰ পরিয়ালবর্গলৈ আমি আমার অসম সরকার তরফের পৰা এককালীন 20 লাখ টকা আর্থিক সাহায্য আমি আগবঢ়াম।
Slain 169th Battalion BSF Jawan from Tripura, Sudeep Sarkar's mortal remains were flown back to his small state Tripura, leading to huge public outcry of outrage against militancy in Kashmir. Sudeep was posted in Kupwara, Kashmir. He and three Indian Army soldiers were killed while fighting terrorists. Minister of Tripura Biplab Deb promised immediate help to the family.
पत्नी जो है और छोटे-छोटे बच्चे हैं, इस इनको कैसे जीवन में आगे लाया जा सकता है, उस बारे में हम लोग सब मिलकर सोचेंगे। साथ ही साथ राज्य सरकार की तरफ से नहीं, अभी जो सीएम रिलीफ फंड से 5 लाख रुपए का चेक हम कल भेज देंगे। बाकी उनका क्या क्या हो सकता है, उनके जो रिलेटिव से इनके साथ मेरे जो सेक्रेटरियल ऑफिसर से बातचीत करेंगे। बीएसएफ की तरफ से जो भी सुविधा वगैरह जो भी है और राज्य सरकार के क्या कर सकते हैं वो।
The close relations between India and Bangladesh received another sweet fillip on Diwali Day with exchange of sweets between Bangladesh's Border Guards or BGB and India's Border Security Force or BSF at Akhaura Checkpost, Tripura on occasion of Diwali and Kali Puja. Talking to the Indian media, BGB Jawan Muhammad Alam wished every Indian and especially the forces happy Diwali.
খুব ভালো লাগছে দিওয়ালি অনুষ্ঠান অনুসরণ করে আমার খুব ভালো লাগছে এতে আমাদের ভারত বাংলাদেশের সৌহার্দ্যপূর্ণ সম্পর্ক সবসময় থাকবে
It is pertinent to note here that a regular border ceremony is held at the Akhaura checkpost every evening which is well attended by people of both sides and also by tourists The ceremony reinforces the friendship between the two countries and gives chance to jawans from both sides to show their valor and also interact with each other. People from far and wide visit this ceremony and raise nationalistic slogans. From India, both men and women personnel of the BSF participate in this event with full nationalistic fervor. Both men and women remain at guard in the Tripura-Bangladesh border round the clock and also help people who live on the borders on both sides. During COVID pandemic, BSF has also provided relief and other materials to people living across the border. Alpha Independent so-called Deputy Commander-in-Chief Drishti Rajkhowa has surrendered along with four accomplices, namely Vedanta, Yasin Assam, Roop Jyoti Assam and Mithun Assam. The group has laid down a huge cache of arms and ammunition and other possessions in front of the Indian Army intelligence agencies. With this surrender, Assam moved huge steps closer to complete peace and elimination of insurgency. It is well known fact that Drishti Rajkhowa was a trusted aide of Alpha I's so-called Commander-in-Chief Paresh Barua. Drishti's surrender is thus a huge blow to Alpha and shot in the arm of our country's security forces and government.
এই আত্মসমৰ্পণে অসমৰ শান্তি প্ৰতিষ্ঠাত যথেষ্ট সহায়কৰ ভূমিকা গ্ৰহণ কৰিব বুলি আমাৰ দৃঢ় বিশ্বাস আৰু অহা দিনবিলাকত মই ভাবো যিসকলে আইনৰ গণ্ডীৰ বাহিৰত আছে তেওঁলোকে অতি সোনকালে আইনৰ গণ্ডীৰ ভিতৰলৈ আহক একেলগে মিলি আমি অসমৰ কাৰণে কাম কৰোঁ শান্তি প্ৰক্ৰিয়াত যোগদান কৰোঁ আৰু আমাৰ মাননীয় মুখ্যমন্ত্ৰী মহোদয়ে সততে কৈ থাকে যে তেখেতৰ এক পৰিকল্পনা আছে সন্ত্ৰাসমুক্ত অসম গঢ়াৰ এই ক্ষেত্ৰত মই ভাবোঁ আজি দৃষ্টি ৰাজখোৱাৰ যি আত্মসমৰ্পণ বা তেওঁৰ লগত যিকেইজন আহিছে চাৰিজন তেওঁলোকৰ এই পদক্ষেপে যথেষ্ট সহায় কৰিব গতিকে আমি এই পদক্ষেপক আদৰণি জনাইছোঁ
Meanwhile, Meghalaya government has also promised to step up vigilance to ensure that no militant uses the state as corridor.
We are duty bound and we will fulfill our duty to see that no criminal will use Meghalaya as the hub or as the corridor to operate any anti-national activities in the state or in the country as a whole.
The Garos of Meghalaya celebrated the 43rd edition of their 100 Drums Wangala Festival albeit in subdued manner due to COVID pandemic. This year for the first time, the festival rituals and dances were held at the proposed permanent site at Achik Heritage Village at Wangala Edam Chibagre. Here we see the Rugala ritual which ensues offering of rice beer, rice and vegetable to traditional deity Missi Saljong, the great giver. The Garos who call themselves as Achik or hill people, as most viewers might be knowing, are the second largest tribe of Meghalaya after the Khasis and comprise of about one-third of the local population of Meghalaya. They are one of the few remaining matrilineal societies of the world. The individuals take their clan titles from their mothers. Traditionally, the youngest daughter called Nokme Chik inherits the property from her mother. In the days of yore, sons used to leave the parents' property at puberty and were trained in the village bachelor dormitory called Nokpante. In earlier days, bachelor men would often be forcefully brought in by the girl's side and kept overnight with a marriageable girl. If both agreed in the morning and this was shown by both bride and groom smoking a bidi, they would be married thereafter in a simple ceremony. We will show you more about the Garos in a segment below.
अब जो शादी हुआ है वो गारो ट्रेडिशन का शादी है, तो उसमें पहले से गारो शादी में पहले से लड़का और लड़की का बीच में प्यार करने का जरूरी नहीं है, लेकिन ऐसा होता है अगर लड़की शादी करने का उम्र में आ गया है तो लड़की का मामा बड़ा भाई जैसा है वो लोग महारी का वो लोग लड़का ढूंढता है, तो लड़का जहाँ भी मिल सकता है, तो अभी हम लोग का अभी जो शादी हुआ है उसमें दोरमितोरी से लड़का मिला है तो उसको लेके आता है, उसके बाद लेके आने के बाद लड़के के घर में लड़की उसको बीड़ी पिलाता है, तो लड़का एक्सेप्ट किया हम लोग देखा है जो, तो एक्सेप्ट करने का मतलब ये हुआ है कि शादी के लिए वो लड़का मंजूर है, तो इसके बाद जो पुजारी है वो शादी परफॉर्म किया, तो उसमें दो मुर्गी का ज़रूरत पड़ गया तो उसको काटा है आप लोग जो देखा है, तो उसके बाद वो तय करके उसमें थोड़ा सा चावल भी चाहिए तो उसको भी उसमें यूज़ किया इस्तेमाल किया, और राइस बियर जो है उसको लोकली हम लोग का भाषा में चुबुची बोलता है उसको भी यूज़ किया, वो लोग को बट लिया, वो लोग खुशी से पी लिया, बस उसमें शादी खत्म हो गया।
Assam Rifles has been rendering different yeoman service in different states of the Northeast to provide sukha to people. Apart from organizing COVID awareness programs, including bike rallies, which are the need of the hour in every state of the region, the force also went out of the way to distribute solar lights to residents of Ziliadjung village, Tamenglong district, Manipur, helped locals to clear massive debris in Changlang district, Arunachal Pradesh, organized friendly football match at Howlan Phai village, Manipur, distributed hearing aids, wheelchairs and other medical essentials in Mokokchung district, Nagaland, all within a span of a week. Additionally, Chikim village in Moray, Manipur got a vocational training center, while in Khulen village, Chandel district, Manipur, a major fire mishap was averted. And in New Tusom village, Ukhrul district, 13 passengers whose bolero met with an accident were rescued. These apart, Assam Rifles completed plantation of 75 lakh saplings all over the Northeast on Diwali Day. They had started this mission in June with target deadline of Diwali. However, the miscreants of the region do not permit good deeds alone. A massive drug racket was nabbed with recovery of 72 kgs of brown sugar worth rupees 287 crore from Kamu village, Thaubal district, Manipur. This apart, illegal foreign goods worth rupees 75 lakh were recovered from Moray, Manipur. Two drug peddlers were nabbed in Mizoram with methamphetamine tablets worth rupees 6.5 crore. 100 kg dry ganja worth rupees 8 lakh were recovered from Gomati district, Tripura. Illegal goods worth rupees 36 lakh were recovered with their couriers at Zubza Nala, Kohima, Nagaland and so on. Devotees dancing and singing of ditties to Lord Sri Krishna and offerings of vast amounts of vegetarian food including rice, fruits, vegetables, dry fruits, etc. marked the joyous celebration of Annakoot festival, the first festival to be celebrated at Tripura capital Agartala's Jagannath Bari post-COVID lockdown. A festival to mark people's gratefulness to Lord Sri Krishna for lifting Govardhan Hill and giving shelter from torrential rains to people of Vrindavan, the mountain of food or Chhappan Bhog, 56 food items, prepared on the occasion becomes a symbol of Govardhan Hill. people offer themselves for shelter in the feet of God on the occasion with the belief that if they donate food, their homes will never face shortage of food.
এটা আমাদের হিন্দু খ্রিস্টি সনাতন খ্রিস্টি এরা আমাদের ভারতে ছিল প্রচলিত অন্নকূট উৎসব অন্নকূটেতে যিনি একটু অন্ন দান করেন একটু অন্ন নেন তার জীবনে কোনোদিন অন্নের অভাব হয় না খাওয়ার অভাব হয় না তারা চিরসুখী হয়ে যান মঙ্গল লাভ করেন ভগবানের কৃপা লাভ করেন ভগবানের ভক্তি লাভ করেন এবং সুখময় জীবন লাভ করেন
We will take a short break here. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back in few seconds time.
First World, a complete monthly magazine of the Northeast, read by who's who of the land. Packaging news and current affairs, sports, culture, festivals, achievers, life in metro and lots more. Buy the magazine today from stalls across the Northeast and New Delhi at Rs. 50 per copy or subscribe for 12 issues by paying Rs. 550 online. For details, contact 98101-29327.
In our last episode, we had shown you a clip of a lady and asked you about her tribe. Well, the correct answer is, she belongs to Garo tribe of Meghalaya. Before announcing the names of the contest winners, watch this short feature on the Garos.
Did you know that Garo people of Meghalaya have a custom of making wooden statues of their dead near and dear ones, clothing them in the garments of the dead, and installing the statues in front of their houses? This is done to reassure the dead that their memories will always be alive in the minds of the living. This and many other rituals make the Garos an interesting study. For even though the majority of them have converted to Christianity, they have nonetheless not given up their age-old customs, which include rituals to appease both the traditional good gods and the bad evil spirits. This, for instance, is the Amua Puja, a ritual to drive away the evil spirits. Seeing this puja, one can note that the offerings to the spirits are the same as the offerings to the gods. In fact, the Garos actually organize prayer ceremonies for both evil and good spirits on every important occasions of their lives, as also at every important stage of agriculture. As farming is the main occupation followed by majority of the Garo people, they practice every means known to them, whether it be hard work on the fields or puja or dances to appease gods for a bumper harvest. Another enduring practice is the tribe's adherence to every word spoken by their village chiefs, who are called Nokma. Interestingly, the Nokmas are not necessarily male. In fact, in the Chidiogre village, we chanced upon a lady Nokma who can be seen here wearing the blue dress. The meeting where disputes are settled by both the Nokma and the judges are called Mela.
Every village in Garo Hills, the Nokma, who is also known as the village head, it can be a lady or a gent, he or she solves all matters concerning the village people in her area. So in case there is a dispute among any particular group, a meeting is called in the village itself, where the Nokma and the elders of the village and the two aggrieved parties are also brought in, and their matter is sorted out over there. So,
today the Garos can be found settled in various parts of India and abroad too. The traditional Wangala dance has become world famous and is performed during many prestigious cultural shows in India and abroad.
Well friends, now let us check out the names of our contest winners.
In our contest section, we had shown you the clip of a lady. We had asked you about her tribe. The tribe is Garo and the state is Meghalaya. The winners are Dare Yongem from Papumpare, Arunachal Pradesh, Fungai Silo from Aizawl, Mizoram, and Monmaya Topno from Guwahati, Assam.
Congratulations, winners! We will recharge your mobile phones with Rs. 500 each. For this week, write back to us about the surrender ceremony we showed in this episode. Who surrendered? Rush in your answers to youth_folio@yahoo.com or SMS or WhatsApp to 98101-29327. See you all next Saturday at 7:30 p.m. on DDSM. Please also look into our earlier episodes on YouTube and don't forget to subscribe to our Vision channel on YouTube. Till next Saturday, this is me Shraddha signing off. Take good care of yourselves. Remember, the virus hasn't gone, so don't let your guards down. Bye-bye.